ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। We are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 9, Chapter number 9 and Text number 8. Iti uktva sah nripah devam tapasa atoshyat shivam kalena Alpiyasa Rajan Tasya Ishaha Cha Asu Atyushyataha Iti Yuktva Svanrupo Devam Tapasa Tochyat Shivam Kalenalpaisya Rajan Tasyesha Chasha Atushyata Iti Uktva. After saying this, Saha, he, Nripaha, the king Bhagirath, Devam, unto Lord Shiva, tapasa, by executing austerities, atoshayat, pleased, Shivam, Lord Shiva, the all auspicious, kaleno, by time, alpiyasha, which was not very long, Rajan, O king, Tasya, upon him, Bhagirath, Ishaha, Lord Shiva, Cha, indeed, Asu, very soon, Atushyata, became satisfied. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. After saying this, Bhagirath satisfied Lord Shiva by performing austerities. O King Parikshit, Lord Shiva was very quickly satisfied with Bhagirath. The words Asu Atushyata indicate that Lord Shiva was satisfied very soon. Therefore, another name of Lord Shiva is Asutosh. Materialistic persons become attached to Lord Shiva because Lord Shiva bestowed benedictions upon anyone and everyone very quickly, not caring to know how his devotees prosper or suffer. Although materialistic persons know that material happiness is nothing but another side of suffering, they want it, and to get it very quickly they worship Lord Shiva. We find that materialists are generally devotees of many demigods, especially Lord Shiva and Mother Durga. They do not actually want spiritual happiness, for it is almost unknown to them. But if one is serious about being happy spiritually, he must take shelter of Lord Vishnu, as Lord personally demands, Sarva Dharmana Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Vraja Aham Tvam Sarva Papebhyo Mokshayishyami Masucha. Abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender to me. I shall deliver you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear. Bhagavad Gita 18 chapter 66th verse. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya चक्षुर्मीलितन्येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकां। वन्देहं श्रीगुरुः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणा ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्णकरुणासिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकान्त राधाकान्त नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि श्रीहरिप्रिय। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिन्निति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वतदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। इति उक्त्वा स नृपो देवं तपसा तोषत इच्छवम्। कालेन अल्पैषा राजन् स्तस्येश्चाशस्तुष्यत। After saying this, Bhagirath satisfied Lord Shiva by performing austerities. O King Parikshit, Lord Shiva was very quickly satisfied with Bhagirath. All right. So, in Vedic Varnashram system, the inclination to liberate the forefathers is the one of the prime duties of the subsequent generations. We see in this case Sagar Maharaj, thousands of children have been burnt by the ashes of to ashes by Kapil Dev. There is saying that Kapil Dev had no desire because he was Lord himself. He is so compassionate. But everybody becomes an instrument in the plan of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So we do not see anything contradictory that being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, why should he be angered and burnt all the sons who came to search the sacrificial horse. The horse was spared, but those who came to rescue, they got burnt. So an apparent reason is to do the welfare at large rather than only to a restricted family. So Anshuman, coming from the Sagar Maharaj dynasty, and Sagar Maharaj wanted to perform this sacrifice, the Ashwamedha Yajna, and therefore the horse had to be traced, and it went all the way up to maybe Ganga Sagar at that time. Kapil Muni's ashram is there, and devotees visit every year. So the idea is that is towards the end of the Ganges, but the Ganges had to come down to purify the tract of the land called Bharatvarsha. So an apparent cause is there, but the effect is so profuse that the entire nation can be saved by this Mother Ganges. It's purifying in order to understand that whatever Krishna does is for the betterment of the jivas. So, in this dynasty, Dilip came, and Dilip tried to take that obligation of the family to liberate the forefathers. But he failed. But his son Bhagirath was very much determined and wanted to sacrifice his life for the betterment of the family members. Even though it is small by our measurement, but the effect will be so great that anybody who takes bath in the Mother Ganges water, they will be all purified. Ganges was brought by the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself. Padanakhani Rajanita Janapavan Keshavadrita Vamana Rupa Jaya Jagadisha Hare. So she is emanating from the Virja where Vamandev raised his second leg to measure the firmament and was able to penetrate through the tip of the toenail. Tip of the toenail. And water started leaking. And Virja is a transcendental river. It's not a material river. Why it is transcendental? Because it flows other way around. Other way around means not from, say, north to south or west to east or east to west. No. It is high up. So it has to come down. Not by gravity. But she has no problem until it went to the upper firmament where the Swargaloka was there. No problem. When she arrived in Swargaloka, it purified all the demigods and reminded that they are all servants of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. She is called Swaradhunya there. She is not called Ganga. But because the effect of the salil, salil means water. But in Achman we do the purification. Water is, it's by itself purifying agent. When we invoke the mantras, Ganga cha Yamuna cha Yava Godavari cha Saraswati Narmade Sindhu Kari Jade Asmin Sannidhim Kuru. Sannidhim means, Nidhi means Samudra, but Sannidhim means collecting the effects of all the purifying reservoirs of water. So, the invocation is a spiritual indication. So Ganga has nothing to do of material benediction, but she has to do all that is purifying and leading towards Krishna. Go back home, back to God. So in those times, the purification was necessary, and they take shelter of the water. The water itself has to be tirtha, means purifying. It's not like stagnant water of today's Jamuna. According to our philosophy, that because Jamuna is part of Ganga, and Krishna played the pastimes, which is spiritual in nature, therefore, however the water of Jamuna is dirty, people will take bath in it. They have no concern for material discomfort or pollution or anything. It becomes a political issue. We are also participating in the purification of Jamuna, or let the water be released from Haryana, which is using 93% of water for the crops and creating pollution by burning the crops after the harvest is taken. This is all political. Ganga or Jamuna doesn't have anything to do with it. So, even by thinking of the holy waters, if we chant the mantra, with a spiritual meaning, then it works the same way. So a small cause, relatively small cause, means to resurrect the family members back to the life and liberate them. Bhagirath has to do all these austerities to please Lord Shiva. Because you must have gone through the conversation between Bhagirath and Ganga itself in the previous chapter. It says definitely. But it is such a tremendous force of Ganga can penetrate the entire planetary system. If it comes in the middle, then it will go downward towards the Rasatal, Patal Lokas. So there must be somebody to restrict the flow. Otherwise, coming all the way from Swarga, what will be the force? Even if you think that there is ultimate gravity there, then it will be tremendous. Even the whole planet can be swept away and can take away, you know, put them into Patal Loka. So there is no possibility. But the ultimate aim is to benedict the living entities, so they can not only fulfill their desires, but at the same time, the aim by such purifying agents will give opportunity for them to be liberated and go back to God. So such a character of Ganga is there. They are directly in connection with the Supreme Personality of Godhead and His desires. She is not a Prakriti, but she is under divine Prakriti. And it is purifying to those who take it under the divinity. There are, even when we take the Achman, there are two general verses that have been utilized. What is that? When you take the Charanamritam, what is the mantra? Achma, and that they know when you take the Charanamritam, what is the mantra? Akala mrityum haranam sarva vyadi vinashanam. Gangotvam pitva punarjanma na vidyate, and somebody says, na shirshe dharmyamaham. Punarjanma na vidyate means it's liberation. But beyond liberation, Sirse Dharmyamyam, generally devotees, Prabhupada gave us this mantra, Sirse Dharmyamyam. I take the purification very, very carefully, committedly through my intelligence, so I can live the life of a purified state. So this is the meaning of tirtha or jal that we have to take it. Now, here is the interaction between Bhagirath and Lord Shiva is to be understood. There are no much details, but in other Puranas there are details. We used to watch this Gangavataran film in our childhood, you know. And there are so many episodes and different kinds of, heightened dialogues and this and that. But anyway, it's a pious nature. But here we get some spiritual nature of, because it is said in Bhagavatam, there must be some spiritual understanding, not only just to apparently get pleased and benedict and this and that. No. Krishna explains this particular part of loka sangraha, means benefiting all the jivas to promote them towards spirituality, is the real purpose of loka sangraha or performance of welfare activities. Ashutosh is the name of Lord Shiva because he can be easily pleased. But you can see immediately that Lord Shiva does not care whether the benediction has gone in favor of the person or disfavor of the person. He can give immediately whatever he wants. It's too easy to please Lord Shiva. Do you want to try? There is only one way for the devotees to try to please Lord Shiva. In Vishnu Sahasranam, it is said in the Mahatmyam that if you chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra in front of Lord Shiva, he will be very pleased. It's a different kind of, and he will give you residence in Vrindavan. So those who are simply visiting, you will not have to visit anymore. You will be the resident of Vrindavan. That is a spiritual benediction. So why Lord Shiva has to do this particular function? To become easily pleased, easily benedict, because there is a spiritual welfare involved in it at large. At large means that there is no boundary. He loves the devotees. Those who are even trying to pray to the Lord to give them their material benedictions, like the Prachetas were going to Bindu Sarovar. It's the residence of Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva was coming out from Bindu Sarovar and he saw the 10 sons of Prachin Barhishat. Because they were going for becoming prajapatis. Now, to become prajapati is a material business. But now, underlying the business is the spiritual welfare. Therefore, they were seeking the benedictions of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And where would they go? They are going to Bindu Sarovar. It is a residence of Lord Shiva. And he was just coming out with his, and he saw these 10 sons of Prachin Parishad. And he immediately started addressing, I know who you are. I know your father. But you are the best of them. Because their father was sunk into Karmakand, and Narad Muni has to take over and to brainwash him. And here, Prachetas were glorified because they have a resolute determination to worship the Supreme. But Shiva wanted to help them. He said, I have put up this hymn, Rudra Gita. It is to please the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And I'm always busy in seeking his favor. Please, you chant. You are going to Bindusarva, you chant this. And Krishna will be easily pleased. So, underlying an apparent philanthropical activity, if it's devoid of Krishna consciousness, then Prabhupada is not interested. Prabhupada is not interested. He didn't say anything to do that kind of welfare activity. And generally, the food for life also is said to be on that basis. Nobody should go hungry in 10-mile radius of a temple. Then what about on 11th mile? Do you have to go there because they cannot come? You have to go and feed them, and that also with the restriction that you cannot chant Hare Krishna in front of them. You can't teach them the spiritual values of prasadam even. There we got. And now the government is indulging. You should feed one egg to the child. What kind of welfare activity is that? I don't want to say something which is more, but our God brother, Jayadeva Swami, he gave a full-fledged seminar on that. Food for death, not food for life. It is food for death, spiritual death. So, are we supposed to look into this kind of thing? This welfare activity just to liberate or bring the burnt bodies, the sons of Sagar Maharaj, the third generation is taking up this particular vow to resurrect them and back into the same body. Kapil Dev is a Supreme Personality of Godhead, and he would have done it without any even Ganges coming down. But looking into the welfare at large means Loka Sangraha. Devotees are supposed to do the welfare activity or the activities in benefit of others only on the spiritual level. If our spiritual purpose is not getting fulfilled, then what is this? It is another entangling business. Anyway, Prabhupada is concluding. There are so many isms and so many adherents of those activities end up into philanthropy only, Christianity. Very little or non-existent spirituality in the philanthropy is just a conversion. Just a conversion. I'm preaching in Kerala also, I know. They did rampant conversions. and they don't know anything about Christianity. They say, we attend our church. The church in the town, Korati Mutti. Korati Mutti says, said to be mother of Jesus, and they worship her. People are mad there. There was a full month of big mela, you know, the same business, but no spirituality. No spirituality. Their definition of spiritual is also different. It's not anti-material. In Christianity, the definition of spiritual is material. So don't get confused. The real purpose will still remain. Prabhupada said that whether you convert yourself into Muslim or Christian, the business of connecting with Supreme Personality of Godhead in loving devotion is still remaining. That is the ultimate spiritual business. So, whatever is lacking the spirituality, Prabhupada never instituted in ISKCON. And if we have a big program, you know, to take over the world, then we should have some kind of very special respect towards Lord Shiva. It means we are not worshipper of demigods. Otherwise, how he will be called Vaishnavanam Yatha Shambhum is our chief. In our ISKCON also, there are many are looking into the demigods as a hateful. That is not the way Prabhupada taught us. We should respect the demigods because they are helping all the living entities to encourage towards the spiritual ultimate goal of life. So, there are so many isms, so many things. But yet, Krishna concludes sarva dharmana parityajyam. This is what is meant by dharman. If it is not directly connecting you with Krishna or the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that you are being part and parcel of Him, you have every right to worship Him directly, of course through the agency of Guru or bona fide teacher. And one of the old conversation in one class, somebody asked Srila Prabhupada in audience, Srila Prabhupada, I am reading Bible. I'm reading Bible. Do I still need a guru? Then Prabhupada said, who wrote the Bible? Whose views are you reading? He becomes your guru. So there are so many are explaining Bible in different ways too. Just like Bhagavad Gita is being explained by Mayavadis, Advaitavadis, so many. Even Christians have developed interest to establish Christ as the Supreme Personality of Godhead through Bhagavad Gita. But if you go in Kerala to distribute Bhagavad Gita, oh no, I'm Christian. I don't read And he is not educated in Bible even. If the devotee is of Western origin, go there and impress upon them. Interfaith, the common mass of Christian, they do not know anything about Bible. You'll be surprised. This is the result of mass conversion. People remain still ignorant. Another surprising thing is that Kerala is the only state where 100% literacy, they claim. But virtually, they know only Malayalam and no English. You will have trouble conversing with them. They don't know Hindi even. You need a Malayali translator. But anyway, the idea is that Lokasangraha is important, and that's Lord Shiva is teaching us that he was easily pleased in order to give the opportunity for the ultimate welfare of whom he pleased. But he wouldn't care for material results to the person who got his benediction. He doesn't care whether he is happy or in distress. You wanted it, you got it. You asked for it, you got it. And no strings attached. No conditions are there. But only underlying factor is that welfare at large. And devotees are supposed to do welfare at large. What is the spiritual welfare? Is encompassing the whole world. So we should keep these traditions, which is very important, according to what Srila Prabhupada ordered, should be executed. So, abandon all varieties of different isms and surrender to Lord Shri Krishna, and he will deliver from all the sinful actions. Sometimes people say, what is a sinful action? To commit a crime is a sinful, yes, I can understand. But to live for simply body is also sinful. Therefore, the deeper value is to kill the Papa Purush. And that is the significance of performing Ekadashi. Why do we fast? Why do we do this? To kill the Papa Purush, so you become spiritually oriented. According to time, place and circumstances, the methodology may be applied, but at the same time, underlying fact also has to be completely kept alive. Just like the seed may be dry, but it has enough moisture to regenerate as soon as the circumstances. That is the application. Otherwise, our bodies are dead. Our bodies are dead. They cannot grow further. So anyway, the spirituality is the most important aspect of all our business in ISKCON. Thank you very much. If you have any question or comment, Jai Kshudi Prabhu.
Seems if we can let the general public know that rather than have the Brahmins do a material sacrifice for you, what we do here is a little different. We get people to do their own sacrifice, even if it's just hear the holy name, see the deities. They get them to sit down and chant one round. So if someone does a sacrifice for Krishna, that's going to be a much greater benefit than having the Brahmins do a material sacrifice for them. So how can we promote this? Or is we already doing that?
Because in Kali Yuga, all the sacrifice is charity and tapa. They are useless. They are actually disqualifying us because we are not qualified. Only qualifying is Harinam. That means those who have performed Harinam, they have performed all the sacrifices and charity and yagyas, you know. That's said. Aho vatasva pachato gariyan yajjihva agre vartate namatubhyam te pastapaha tapasu. Kunti is telling, he has performed all these activities of tapascharya and brahmanurcharanam ye grananti ete. This is the direct address and connection to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. While tapa is an indirect, it is purifying. But we are not qualified to get purified by it because we do not know anything. We are limited. So chant Hare Krishna and do not go into much detail of it. In the beginning, where were the qualified brahmanas there with Srila Prabhupada? Prabhupada wanted all the devotees to become brahmana, not to become so much engaged into karmakanda section, but essential aspects only. I'm sorry to say that in Vrindavan, this brahmana is becoming an industry. The prices are jacking up, and they are not ashamed even with our devotees. Anything. Haribol.
Then Maharaj, I want to know for which purpose the devotees are advised to ask permission to Gopeshwar Mahadev before doing Vrindavan Parikrama, as is also kind of Lord Shiva worship, and for what purpose the devotees are advised to do that?
Worship, bowing down. These are the aspects of Navada Bhakti. It is applied to a devotee also. Isn't it Lord Shiva pure devotee? Then if person do not know more than that they are demigods and they are living entities just like one of us, but they are not ordinary people. They have been chosen by Lord Krishna and entrusted. So there is a difference. Of course, ignorant people can, they are suggested to go and take permission from the Guru. I don't think a Guru will deny them. That's also an etiquette that is to be observed by the neophyte devotees. Anything? Yes? Can you say that? We are not supposed to establish Varnashram system. We are supposed to establish Daivi Varnashram system. What is Daivi? Daivi means spiritual. It might have a form externally of Varna Ashram, but it doesn't have an internal structure of differentiation because it's Vaishnava. To make Varna Ashram is a practical way to show the idealism of Varna Ashram, to show to others. But we follow Vaishnavism. We do not become, materialistic or karmakandi through Daivi Varna Ashram system. There is immunity of spiritual life there. If that is predominant, then where is the question of, entering into the material affairs? Well, Prabhupada gave us like spiritual management. It's part of Daivi Varna Ashram system. We start from the topmost of the spirituality and go on the practicality, means through the bodily conception. So it has to touch that part off. Otherwise, how our entirety will be purified? Unless we practice, that becomes ideal. Previously, there was the Varna Ashram system in Satya Yuga, but then it starts breaking because all the four legs, one by one, disappear. In Kali Yuga, hardly little. Truth of the nature of the absoluteness is still existing, and that we are receiving. What else is there to help us? Other is for Loka Sangraha. To become, to establish the Daivi Varna Ashram system is also to become, exemplary to others. But we should not become so much disintegrated as and the caste system, and then reject and then go for reservations. No, it's all material. It divides and divides. Okay. Thank you very much, great souls. Srila Prabhupada ki.